he was just 600 grams when he was born, and now he is 2.3 kg.
Hi, my name is Junius Kuriakos, and she's my wife, Sharon Sam. On 27th of October 2017, we got married, and that was a memorable day for us. Post the marriage, we were in Delhi. We were expecting a baby. So for almost 3 years, we didn't have a kid. We also went to the doctor and checked about the same. Doctors gave us some medicines. But on March 2020, Sharon got to know that she was conceived.
I had PCOD issue, and it was a challenging time for me. But at the same time, we were very happy, you know, that God has given us this gift. And I had a lot of complications, like in every scan, whatever we had, the gynecologist told me that the reports were not so normal, as the baby had a lump in his neck. So we were worried. In the next scan, the doctor said that the lump is no more, but a new complication arose. He had low set of ears. So that was a time that they were detecting that the baby could have Down syndrome or some other complication in future. We had full faith that God is a miracle worker. And one of my doctor whom I was consulting, even she said that at a point of time that after seeing all the scan reports that you need to terminate the baby. At the 4th month, I started having high BP. So that was a time when it was at risk, both the baby and me. So me and my husband, we rushed to the hospital and we met the doctor. My scan was done. And that's when the doctor told me that the baby started coming out from the placenta. That means that you are going into PIH, as my BP was really high and it was a risk to him and to me. So either I might, you know, lose my life or the baby might lose life. Nothing can be said, but this risk has to be taken, and I was admitted.
And all the procedures, whatever has to be done for delivery, they started to do it. And the next day, Sharon started to have a very severe pain in her abdomen. And at that moment, doctor said, you know, anytime now, Sharon is going to deliver the baby. So I was excited, in another part, I was also in fear that, you know, what's going to happen, because all these time doctors have told us to do, you know, during the scan that, you know, baby has some abnormalities, you know, the test shows us the negative reports. We really didn't know what to do. As Sharon got admitted right away at the night, 6th of August, I called Pastor. I said, Pastor Shine, you know, Sharon is admitted in the hospital now. Anytime now, Sharon would deliver a baby. Pastor said, you know, I'll definitely keep you in my prayers, and we're going to pray for you. Don't worry about anything which is going to happen. Just have faith and just keep praying.
The next day, I delivered the baby. It was a normal delivery. So I was conscious during my delivery. No anesthesia was given to me. So the first thing that I asked was, is the baby all right? And I could hear my baby crying. And that's when, you know, in 25 weeks, at that time, the survival rate is so less that I was like, oh Lord, what should be done in next few hours? I could hear the doctors talking to my husband, and Junius was tensed. I could see him.
As soon as the doctor said, you know, baby's crying, which is very good, but what you want to do now, right now? So I said, no, doctor, we definitely want that kid, because since last 3 years and we were praying, this is the baby boy which God has given to us. We don't want to lose him. At that moment, doctor took him in the incubator, and he was shifted to NICU, wherein he was there for almost 2 months. First week, you know, doctor were telling, you know, he's doing well. He's breathing. He was just in ventilator for 2 days, and he was moved into CPAP, which is a less oxygen support given to the baby. Another week, we used to get a call, and doctor used to tell that, you know, baby has a blood clot in his head, you know, which is in stage two. Post that, you know, baby had a problem in breathing because his lungs were not mature. He was very tiny. He couldn't breathe without any support. So I still remember when wife delivered the baby, they were taking in the incubator. It was very tiny. You know, I couldn't recognize the face. You know, it was not fully formed. His body was so fragile. And every week, doctors used to call and give us an update. You know, some or other time, the blood count was very less in the body. And, you know, he has to have a blood transfusion. There was few slight infections. There were multiple complications baby had. But still, God is a faithful God. And we were just praying and thinking and just saying to the Lord, Lord, this is the gift that you've given to us. He was almost 2 months in the hospital. Every now and then we used to get an update. And the day when he got discharged from the hospital, everyone were so happy to see him because he was there for almost 2 months. And you know, doctor said, it is not me who have treated your baby. It is the wisdom of God. And it is God who has blessed the baby.
It's been 3 weeks that he has been discharged and we have brought him back. I wanted to tell that he was just 600 grams when he was born. And now he is 2.3 kg, all healthy.
We were thanking God, saying that how great you are. I used to sing the songs saying that, you know, it's your breath in his lungs, so we call out your praise. So I don't know if he sings or not, but yeah, he lifts his hands, and whenever I sing this song, he has that smile in his face. So this is the gift of God, and we really would like to thank each and everyone who were praying for us, who supported us. The topmost challenge that we faced was the financial crisis, because the bill that we had was 18 lakhs. I didn't have any amount more than 50,000 in my bank, and we were just praying, and I was telling Sharon that, you know, we're going to pray, and we strongly feel that, you know, God will provide, because this is the baby that God has given to us. He will never forsake us. God has been so faithful to us and shown His grace towards us. God met all our financial needs. Definitely, I would say God has helped us in all these financial circumstances. And I would like to say thank you to everyone who have prayed, all our friends, relatives, our church, all my dear pastors who have been with us, supported us in each and every moment, and would really want to thank with all our hearts as our family. We want to say thank you that you have helped baby Gerald. I would like to say one thing that definitely encouraged me during the situation, that was the faith. This situation which brought to us seems like a big, huge mountain. And we thought that we will not be able to manage all our financial problems, all our challenges which baby had. For us, it was impossible. But I said, Lord, it is you who have given this baby. And I strongly feel that, God, it is your gift. You're going to bless him. You're going to lead him. I'm not going to ask you any questions. As a family, we strongly feel that you're going to lead us. So that faith we had, and I want to encourage each and everyone who are watching this video. I would like to say that in front of you, you will feel that, you know, it is impossible, but God says everything is possible through God.